Correspondents!
Hello?
It's me, Todd Kraines.
Okay.
Hi.
Hi, what's going on?
How's dinner?
All right, you have a good evening.
All right, love you, Mom.
No one will ever forget the Todd Kraines prank when he used to call Kris Jenner up on the phone and be like, hi, it's me.
Auntie Kris, it's me. It's Todd Kraines. Where are you? Todd Kraines.
Auntie Kris.
She didn't know what was going on.
And the waiter comes over and he goes, Mrs. Jenner, here's a glass of champagne. It's from Todd Kraines. And I go,
can I have a heart attack?
Yesterday, I got flowers. And it said, dear Auntie Kris, why do you keep on hanging up on me?
They finally decided to bring the real Todd Kraines one time.
Auntie Kris, it's me, Todd Kraines.
Hi, Toddy Dice.
It was the prank of all pranks, and it definitely tops the Ard Van Delay prank, which secretly I wasn't so personally down with. Scott has had some crazy moments. What about him deciding to be the Lord? I mean, that's literally his handle on Instagram. And you know what? He manifested that shit for himself. He literally bought the title on the internet and then got knighted in London.
And will be true to the laws of England and Wales.
And be true to the Lord
of... To the laws of England and Wales.
To the laws of England and Wales.
Amen.
Amen.
You just mind lowering your head slightly? I dub thee Lord of the Manor. Please rise, Scott, Lord of the Manor.
I'm feeling royal.
Can we flash back to when he would just wear suits every single day, no matter what he was doing?
And he used to walk around with that
cane.
And he used to slick his hair back and wear his like three-piece suits walking down the street.
Now that I'm like thinking about it, Scott probably was like, I'm never gonna get the last name Kardashian. What's the next best thing? I'm gonna become Lord.
Thank you.
Looks smashing.
Oh, yeah. You disgusting human beings. Feed the Lord!
Colt, it wasn't always fun and games with Scott. As we know, it was one hell of an emotional roller coaster. But what we actually saw on the show, and no one will ever forget this, is the scene where he shoved the money in the waiter's mouth in Vegas.
I can't get you to shut your...
Well, now.
Shut your...
It's so bad to laugh because it is like assault.
So right before this memorable moment, one of the most memorable things to happen with Scott and Rob, and like, oh my God, I love their friendship, was them wrestling in the hotel and Kourtney calling them drunk slob kebabs.
You're acting like drunk slob kebabs and Kim doesn't want drunks, wasted people at her dinner.
Could you imagine if that happened today where Scott shoved the $100 bill in a waiter's mouth? First of all, I'm shocked that waiter didn't sue.
Yeah, I'm sure Kris Jenner handled that situation because they were drunk slob kebabs. This was Kim Kardashian's birthday trip. Like, she was supposed to be there to promote herself, to have a club appearance, and Kris Jenner had to cut Scott Disick off at the bar, and that's why this whole thing happened.
What Scott really wants to be doing is do to me what he's doing to the waiter, because Scott knows I'm the one who cut him off.
And like, this is where the conundrum is. It's like, we love Scott Disick, but then he has these moments where it's like, oh, we remember.
But Scott had such redeemable moments, and he obviously had this like close relationship with Kourtney and with the family that no one could really have again. He kind of like grew up with them. The moments they shared together were so intimate. Like, do you remember when he was trimming her lady parts because she couldn't see her vagina before giving birth?
Do I remember? I think about this, I think, more times than I should.
You were upset that I don't want to shave for the photo shoot.
Yeah, it's a little offensive.
First of all, it's lucky enough that I can shave my legs. There's a huge stomach hair in the way. So, like, you're asking a lot to shave down there, but I'm down. I just need some assistance.
I could trim you up real nice. It's going to run you at about $13.50, though. Her bush is hanging out like it's the 80s, and I'm not going to stand for that. So if I got to get my hands dirty, I will.
Scott literally trimmed for her, which in my opinion is like romantic, but Chloe was also in the room. Everyone was watching. I mean, these were the days, you know, these were the days.
This is disgusting.
Are you looking at what you're doing? Because I can't see.
He's looking.
You're
kidding.
Buddy.
This reminds me of a water birth.
I mean, that's a whole other level of closeness. I'm sure that Travis, like, I don't want to know. He braids him. Yeah. He's putting it back on his head as a little memorabilia.
I do feel bad for Scott because he really was invested in Kourtney. And I think the entire love storyline, he wanted that notebook worthy moment. He wanted to have the love story of all love stories, even recreating. Oh my God, now that I'm thinking about it, can we like do a sexy scene moment? Scott Disick shirtless, like, he's hot. And he was so tan.
Oh my God, that's why you love him, because he was so freaking tan.
The tan is getting me.
But oh my God, the notebook scene. During that episode, that Kourtney was kind of disappointed. She was like, I watched these movies about true love, and like, what we're doing like doesn't have that vibe. And then he did it for her.
What are you doing?
And he was just like saying the notebook lines.
I wrote you 98 times on text message. I've been waiting for you for so long to get back here. I can't quit you. Don't you get it?
Scott had so many amazing one-liners that, again, I feel like are just the best in the show's history.
He checks those bitches. He brings them back down to reality. I love when Scott calls Kim out. When Kim was telling him to take it slow.
Didn't you get married both times after a couple of months?
Okay, this was so savage. Do you remember when Scott said to Kendall,
Rob hasn't come out of the house in 3 or 4 years. Then he knocked up his girlfriend after 2 weeks of knowing her. And then there were some other problems that went on in between then. So if you think you got it rough, just take a look at us.
Oh my God. Fast forward now, I'm like, damn, that was like savage.
I won't forget when they were filming some sort of a special and Kris was asked what her favorite day was.
Probably the day that Oprah came over.
Not when Penelope was born. You heartless wench.
Like, he's so quick-witted.
One of Scott Disick's one-liners actually is viral on TikTok where he's like,
you know, I've realized that I'm probably just perfect and it's everybody else around me that's got issues.
One got picked up quick.
But you know what else I remember, Colt?
What?
When, do you remember there was a moment where Kourtney, there was a scare that she might have a sex tape come out about her or something and she was upset? And then Scott was like,
you know how I have sex pictures when I was 17?
No.
With Jeff?
Sure.
Someone's trying to like sell them to everyone.
And that was before your boob job, is that why you're mad?
No.
Oh my God, Scott.
Who would say that in like such a vulnerable moment?
Even when like Kim Kardashian was like, I want a flat ass, and Scott Disick is like,
you guys are famous for big butts.
But her,
you guys lose your butts, like, we may all lose their money.
Seeing Scott Disick and Kourtney recreate Caitlyn and Kris Jenner's sex tape was something I think it's ingrained in my brain forever.
You got a Viagra on you?
We're not using condoms or anything.
No, I'm gonna go raw.
When I started having sex in the 70s, it was a lot of this and a lot of that.
And action.
Hi guys, I'm Kris Jenner.
I'm Bruce. You may remember me from the Olympic Games.
Oh yeah, man. Okay, daddy's daddy's
I'm not rolling yet.
Uh-oh. Hi guys.
Scott, don't look at me.
We're rolling.
Give me dirty. We gotta get your legs over my shoulders.
No.
Holy bro, I'm getting annihilated.
Spill your wine, honey.
Kourtney looks like Kris so much with short hair.
Oh, God.
She looks just like mom. It's perfect.
Do you remember when Kourtney walked around with a dildo around the house all day because Scott wanted to do it up the
Is this some kind of joke?
Suck it.
Get out of here, you little freak.
Oh, yeah.
Stop it. Are you nuts? Ew. Get that away.
I'm just having way too much fun with it.
We used to be able to watch on TV a whole storyline about how Scott wants to do it up the Kourtney doesn't, and they have continuous conversations about it.
You're a big bad dork fan, right?
Ew, you guys. What is it with grown men and always wanting to put things where they don't belong?
And then she gets so annoyed that she ends up buying this dildo, tying it around herself. Ugh.
Kourtney was ahead of her time for that one. That is like, if you want my back door, well, then your back door needs to be open too.
Exactly.
But let me tell you, that dildo she was flapping around, that would not be pleasant for the first time.
So what's your favorite Scott Disick moment? Let us know in the comments below.
And make sure to check out all of our past episodes in case you missed them.
And don't forget to subscribe.
Todd Kraines.